Good afternoon. I'm Mike Spear with Genome Alberta. We're in the BioBuzz area at BioBoston in the Boston Convention Center, which is a really impressive place, I must admit. You can follow me as @MikesGene on Twitter. You can, of course, follow I Am Biotech. And I'm joined this afternoon by Thomas Lukasik. He's the Deputy Premier for the province of Alberta. And for those of you who are American and don't quite understand what a premier is, it's like the governor of a state. And Thomas Lukasik is the Deputy Premier. Good afternoon, Thomas.
Good afternoon. Pleasure to be here.
So have you been enjoying bio so far?
I have. I have to tell you, it's really, credit goes to the organizers of this event. It's a phenomenal world-class event. And what's interesting, being here from Canada, I'm running into Canadians and I actually have an opportunity to meet with more Canadian companies here in Boston than I had the opportunity to do so in Canada. So it's a great opportunity to really enjoying ourselves.
Good. Now, for biotech and life science companies to come to Alberta, what do you see as some of the advantages? Where do they see the strengths to operate in Alberta?
Well, there are a number of advantages. Our fiscal positioning in Canada and in North America, and frankly worldwide, is very strong. So they're recognizing that Alberta is in a position of strength from a fiscal perspective, very stable government, and the phenomenal post-secondary and research institutions that have been recognized. They also realize that Alberta is not only one of the leaders on the human side of research, but also on the animal side of research, having agriculture being our second largest industry, combined with the petroleum industry. So there are synergies that are developing. Plus, Alberta is making a very conscious decision to reprofile itself and be known for knowledge-based economy. So that is the reason why we are here. Promote Alberta as a province in which to invest and in which to flourish the biotech economy.
Now, the Alberta economy right now is fairly robust, but there's challenges all over the world with economies. There's got to be some challenges to companies working in Alberta. What do you see as kind of some of the obstacles that we need to work on?
Well, obstacles, they're challenges, but challenges that we can overcome. One of the overarching themes that I see developing right now, having met with a number of companies, not only Canadian, but companies from throughout the world, is the regulatory process. Canada having provincial governments, much like in the United States having state governments, very often we may have different sets of regulations that govern the industry, and very often industry that wants to enter the country has to deal with individual states or individual provinces. So harmonizing our regulatory process is something that we definitely need to look at, and that will be one of the take-home, my homework assignment from here, is to speak to my counterparts Canada-wide and see what can we do to harmonize our regulatory system so that we become more friendly towards company coming from outside in. Venture capital, we're all vying for the same dollar, so venture capital obviously is one of the obstacles that all of us are facing. But all in all, when you look at the size of bioeconomy in Canada, relevant to the population of the country, we are quite a robust player in the market, and we can only grow. So now we are here to find out what our weaknesses are, where we need to improve our performance, and what are we doing right that we should be doing more of. Companies have been very generous in sharing information and advising us on what they think from their perspective would improve our marketability.
Now, companies generous in sharing what they see is should be done can be interpreted in a lot of ways. What's the strongest message you've been getting from companies that are looking towards Alberta, or at least thinking about, maybe that's not a bad place to set up?
Well, the message I'm leaving them with is this. I want them to be successful in Alberta. I want them to make money in Alberta. But at the same time, I want to make sure that as a result of that, we are providing citizens of our province, of our country, with the best quality of healthcare available, with the right medications at the right time, and at the end of the day, both of us are in the business of improving the quality of life of our citizens. But we are very much interested in making sure that they flourish as businesses so that they can reinvest in developing new protocols and new products for the market. So I think our goals are common. But we're competing against some fine players worldwide. You're looking over here at a booth not only from every country, but from every part of every country in the world, and we're after the same goal. collaboration will be the strength in Canada. We have to look at a collaborative approach between provinces. We have to identify what our strengths truly are and where we simply will not be competitive relevant to other jurisdictions and focus very narrowly on our strengths. In Alberta, our strengths are the fact that we are in a strong fiscal position. We have a strong agriculture industry. And our oil and petroleum industry, those are natural synergies that allow us to be competitive. And with our post-secondary institutions and the research and development that is already going on, plus a government that is very much business-friendly, singularly focused on improving the quality of healthcare offered to our citizens. You put all that together, and when we sit down around the table with companies, I think we have developed a common language where they're seeing that this is a province that at least is receptive to further investment, further collaborations, further research, and who knows, perhaps even manufacturing at one point in time.
Now, I talked to Minister Stephen Kahn earlier today about his department and the newly formed ministry that includes enterprise and advanced education. And certainly one of the questions that comes up when that happened, that word enterprise popped up with the research committee, was where does that put some of the basic science research? Because everything you've talked about has been fairly heavily on commercialization and innovation. Where does basic research and how do you see the province nurturing that along? Because a lot of that research can be 5 to 7 years out. It's not going to produce a widget tomorrow.
But we're fully aware of the fact that everything starts with basic science. Everything starts at one point in time in a petri dish. So growing our basic science in our post-secondary public institutions is a good beginning. And growing not only the technologies, but growing the human capital. Growing our own well-educated scientists who then can elevate basic science into higher levels and hopefully attract investment to commercialize the product. So you simply don't start with products that are ready to be commercialized. You have to grow that basic science and develop those products from scratch. And we are aware of that. That is why we have been investing so heavily in education. And that is why we are expanding not only investment in the actual teaching, but also our capital expenditure in post-secondary education is growing, because we realize that we need to grow the basic science, develop a nurturing environment for scientists to want to live in Alberta and hone their skills in Alberta, so that once they get to the point where they actually develop products that have a potential of being commercialized, they will continue doing that in Alberta.
Now, Premier Redford has said many times that she sees Alberta well situated to take some of these leadership roles and to help coordinate certain areas in Canada. Do you see, you touched on earlier in the area of biotech and life sciences, apart from regulatory, do you think Alberta as a province is in a good position these days to look at the rest of the country and say, here's where we can go as a country, or here's where this region can go, or maybe this region should specialize in something else?
Most definitely. As a matter of fact, we have shown leadership on other fronts. We are developing Canadian energy strategy and having other provinces collaborate. We have initiated labor mobility throughout the country and recognition of credentials throughout the country. So this is one more area where we can take leadership. And you have to be quite frank and honest with yourself. We cannot be the best at everything. There are other provinces that are best positioned to excel in other areas. And as long as you are willing to acknowledge your areas of strength and weaknesses and support other provinces in their areas of strength. Because at the end of the day, when the tide rises, all boats go up. And we have to make sure that we support each other. We're a country of just slightly over 32 million people. We're competing against world markets. We have to make sure that we identify our areas of strength, develop those while assisting other parts of jurisdiction. So this healthy, constructive competition internally is good, as long as it is constructive, because at the end of the day, as Canadians, we are competing against the rest of the world.
Now, is this your first trip to Bio?
Yes, it is.
You must have come across an awful lot of technology and an awful lot of subject area that you have never seen before. How has that been?
Well, this is overwhelming. As citizens, as individuals, we hope to have as little interaction with health systems as possible. But when you realize what technologies exist and what technologies actually are possible, what is being developed, And the impact they can have upon humanity, not only in curing diseases, but improving quality of life. This is phenomenal, and that should be shaping our policy dialogues. You know, often we look at medications as a pill that cures a disease, but we also have to look at the quality of life. Those pills allow individuals to go faster to work. Those pills allow individuals not to have to rely on other secondary services. It's just amazing what is possible and what is available. Now, as governments, you know, we're not always in position to pay for everything all the time. So we have to make those difficult decisions. What is best investment on behalf of our citizens, and what technologies do we invest in? What protocols do we list on our list of listed protocols under our public healthcare systems? Difficult decisions, but growing this industry is so important, not only for economic development, but to elevating the quality of life.
Now, they tell me you're very active on Twitter.
I am.
What's your Twitter handle?
It's Lukaszmla, Lukaszmla.
Very good. We expect everybody to follow you.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thanks for your time this afternoon.
Thank you. Good stuff.